viscosity measurement. All fluids, liquids and gases exhibit a characteristic property of flowing under an applied force, which could be even the force of their own weight, and also the ease which they flow differs from the liquid to liquid. The property of resistance to flow when a stress is applied to a liquid is called its viscosity. Here, aim is to find the absolute viscosity and the unknown composition of a given mixture. Now the apparatus used: wash bottle, stopwatch, Ostwald's viscometer, unknown liquid, pycnometer or RD bottle, pipette, a weighing balance. Ostwald's viscometer is a traditional viscometer to measure the viscosity of a liquid. It is a U-shaped glass tube. In one arm, the bulb A is connected with a fine capillary. The lower end of a capillary is connected with a U-tube provided with a bulb B in the second arm. The bulb B is necessary to maintain the hydrostatic pressure during the flow of liquid. Through the capillary tube, the liquid flows with measurable speed. There are two marks, C and D, above and below the bulb A. The liquid flows under its own weight. The density of liquid is determined either by pycnometer or by RD bottle. Now the procedure. Clean the viscometer with chromic acid and then wash thoroughly with the distilled water. It is then washed with alcohol or acetone and dry. A sufficient volume of distilled water is introduced by pipette in bulb B so that the bent portion of tube and half or a little more than half of bulb B are filled up. Clamp the viscometer in quite a vertical position. Using the pipette pump, suck up water until it rises above the upper mark C and allows it to flow under its own weight. The time of flow of water from C to D is counted by starting the stopwatch as the meniscus just reaches the upper mark C and stopping the watch as the meniscus just passes the lower mark D. Take at least 3 or 4 readings with water and then take the mean of them. Now remove the water from viscometer and dry it. Introduce in bulb B the same volume of liquid and measure the time of flow of liquid as before. Take at least 3 or 4 readings and then take the mean value. Now wash and dry the pycometer or RD bottle and then weight it empty. Then fill it with distilled water and weigh. Remove water and dry. Then fill it with experimental liquid and weigh. Note the room temperature also. Thus, the absolute viscosity of a given liquid can be found out using the formulae. Similarly, the unknown composition of given mixture can also be found by plotting a graph, time of flow in second versus composition of given mixture